Athene heeft een probleem. Een groot probleem. Wie door de straten van Athene loopt, ziet al gauw de vele daklozen over de pleinen en stegen struinen. In de Griekse hoofdstad wordt het aantal daklozen geschat op 20.000 en het is daarmee een van de steden met het hoogste aantal daklozen in Europa. Gelukkig schiet de Griekse gemeenschap te hulp en met lokale initiatieven proberen zij deze mensen te ondersteunen. Nou, we zijn hier in de buitenwijken van Athene en een van die lokale initiatieven die zijn ondernomen, dat is deze Metropolitan Clinic. Daar heb ik afgesproken met twee vrijwilligers die gratis medicijnen en hulp verstrekken aan mensen die geen verzekering hebben of die gewoon helemaal geen geld hebben. Dus ik heb gehoord dat deze mensen bijzonder werk verrichten. Dus gaan kijken of deze twee vrijwilligers ons meer kunnen vertellen over deze kliniek.
De kliniek started in 2011.
Okay.
All the people here are volunteers. Does not accept money. Only medicines and the services. Okay. From doctors or other persons, that we do not advertise someone that offers some here.
Wow.
Also the patients, many of patients becomes volunteer.
Okay.
There is a solidarity, mm-hmm. Not charity, not a...
Yeah, it's solidarity, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
What's the matter? Open your nose.
You can see that they put the date,
mm-hmm.
That they
yeah, that's
the, yes. And how many medicine are there inside,
okay.
Because they must give from, they must combine with someone give as a medicine.
But you don't give a full box, you give
one, okay. Yes,
okay.
So the people here have to take off to
get the right amount.
To ride in, in order to be easy to take two or three boxes in mm-hmm. order to give the patients.
Okay, okay.
But the medicines are coming from people from Greece and abroad. We have a lot of medicines from Europe, from citizens of Europe, yeah. No government or other organizations, only citizens. And
But why are the people from Central of Europe bringing their medicine to this pretty small clinic over here? How do we
about all the countries of Holland, Germany, France, okay. Italy, England, Spain. We have from all the countries of West Europe. The problem continues.
Yeah.
To be the poor people are the same or more,
mm-hmm.
because in the beginning everybody has some money.
Put on the side.
Yes.
Yeah.
And now there are not this money.
Okay.
So the problem is bigger for many people. The crisis continues to be. And now we accept also people who have insurance, but they can't buy their medicines.
Okay. Yeah.
In the past we had only uninsurance people.
Mm-hmm.
All these refrigerators are offers,
mm-hmm.
And here are medicines from Tukatakarkinika, so Telefteo. It's for cancer, very expensive medicines.
Okay, so the people who don't have the insurance can get their cancer medicines here?
Yes.
Okay.
For example, there are medicines that one box has 5,000 euros.
Oh, wow. 5,000 euros for one box?
Yes.
Wow. Maybe. And you give it for free?
Yes.
Wow, that's very...
Yes, we have about 500 patients that come every month.
Okay.
And many others that wants to take for the babies milk, plumbers, and also other things that they don't write in papers from doctors. For example, if you have a leg and you want some
Yes.
They must pay for this, so we give also free. Yes.
Okay.
Dimitris Balakas is een van de 300 vrijwilligers van de kliniek. Zo'n 6 jaar geleden stapte hij daar voor het eerst binnen.
Medicines through prescription. So we have to have pharmacists. This is a legal obligation. No, that a pharmacist should check and deliver a pharmacist properly.
Who are the people who come here? They don't have an insurance.
Well, there are people that first of all, they don't have insurance, but also people that they have insurance, but they don't, they are not able financially to pay this patient merit in getting the drugs. Actually, mm-hmm. There is a participation of the patient, in some cases 10%, some cases 20%. People they cannot afford to pay this share.
Okay, so they come here to get their medicine.
That's the case. That's the case. And then they are homeless and or other people or refugees. Mm-hmm. Also, we are supporting mm-hmm. refugees from the war of Syria or from other parts of the world.
Okay.
Well, future is not bright. Not only for Greek people, but also in other areas of Europe. But we are not we are not allowed to give up.
No.
So what we we're doing here is, on top of giving pharmacies, we are also pushing governments and political parties to solve these social problems that are arising from their implementation of their policies mm-hmm. in the end of the day.
Well, everyone here is equal and as a person that wants to offer solidarity to people and to press the government to do something that must do.
We lopen in het stadsdeel Omonia, waar een organisatie zit, die heet Garitas. Want de gemeente Athene is niet de enige organisatie die mensen met weinig geld of immigranten probeert te helpen. Deze organisatie is verbonden aan de kerk en ze geven gratis maaltijden weg en blijkbaar ook kleren en ze bieden onderdak. Dus we gaan even kijken wat daar zoal gebeurt en dat is als het goed is hier om de hoek. In de keuken werkt de goedlachse Australische Julia Roberts. Ze werkt een maand op vrijwillige basis voor Garitas.
And we get donations. I don't know where the donations come from, but yesterday we had a big plate of cakes.
Okay.
Very nice cakes.
Yeah.
And a lot of other things. But today it doesn't look very rich.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how many people a day?
Well, now it's Ramadan.
Yeah.
And because we have a lot of people from Afghanistan, a lot of Muslims and stuff. We don't know
okay.
who anyone is,
okay.
but at the moment I think we're getting about 300 a day,
okay.
but after Ramadan it can be over 600 every day.
Wow.
It's a lot, I know.
That's a lot.
I'm the chief plate scraper, so yeah.
So you have a lot to do. All right, and you said there are a lot of volunteers. Do you know how much? How many?
Oh, every day it's a different day.
Okay.
Some people come in every Monday or every Wednesday or something.
Okay.
Me, I'm only here for a month, so I try to come in every day.
Okay.
It gives me something to do.
Yeah.
And it's nice to smile at them and say thank you.
Yeah.
You know,
okay.
because they must feel bad.
Yeah.
You know.
So, what's on the menu today?
We're having bean soup with rice. Vegetable and bean soup with rice.
Yeah.
Yesterday it was a pasta with a meat sauce.
Okay.
And then the next time they do lentil soups and different things, whatever we have.
Alright. Alright. Het is rond etenstijd en enkele tientallen mensen druppelen bij Garitas binnen. Het zijn vooral senioren en ouders met kinderen. Het is treurig om te zien hoe die kinderen bij binnenkomst meteen richting de prullenbak lopen om te kijken wat erin ligt. Is dat toeval of is het inmiddels aangeleerd gedrag? Tekenend is het in ieder geval wel.
Did you see more people coming in also after the crisis? Because
yeah, I'm here for the last 10 years.
Yeah.
What I can see is these last years, 2 or 3 years, we have more Greeks
yeah.
than 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that Greeks did not feel very well to come here
okay.
and ask for food. They were not talking, they were like that. Now they've seen that there are a lot of other Greeks that come, so they speak, they say good morning loudly, Kalimera. And that's what I've noticed.
Okay, so they were a bit of ashamed to come here. So this organization is connected with the church?
Yes, from the Catholic Church,
okay.
this organization.
Okay, because we saw not only this food kitchen, mm-hmm. but there are a lot of food, soup kitchen in Athens.
Yeah.
But also a lot of are ran by Orthodox Church, mm-hmm. Catholic Church. Mm-hmm. Does the church also always plays a big part in the community?
Yeah.
And why they are doing that?
They are doing that because if somebody is a Christian, has learned from his early childhood, we have to love, to help other people. So the Catholic Church has the Caritas, it is an international organization.
Yeah.
And this building with the soup kitchen exists from 1979.
Okay.
Helping refugees, immigrants, homeless people. Last years this has increased.
Okay. Okay. So and that also has to do with the crisis, or
maybe it increased because of the crisis, the Syrian crisis, not only the economic crisis in Greece, because most of them are not Greeks. Most of them, a small percentage.
Okay.
Always, a government could do more.
Yeah.
Governments in general could do more, but it's not my decision. I would like to happen one day that I'm not anymore needed here. This whole place should close because there are no needs. That's why, because the people out there need this place, and places like this, to have a hot meal. To have a smile. Welcome. How are you?
De afgelopen dagen heb ik veel gezien in Athene. Van prachtige bouwwerken van duizenden jaren geleden tot gekraakte panden in een van de armste wijken van de stad. Hoewel de economische crisis inmiddels van de voorpagina's is verdwenen, is het me duidelijk geworden dat de problemen nog steeds volop zichtbaar zijn. De wederopbouw is begonnen, maar Griekenland heeft nog een lange weg te gaan. Want ook vanavond zoeken duizenden daklozen in Athene alleen een nieuwe plek om de nacht door te brengen.